There we go. So can you hear me? I hope this works better. Put that turn on. Play again, finish back. Ah. Oh. Back post. Yeah, so what I was saying is that basically this isn't a real match. Actually, this is because normally we'd want to play an ultimate team, right? I can't kick these shots away. But since we can't get an ultimate team right now, we're just playing this game mode just to see if the online works. Online matchmaking wasn't working on ultimate teams, so we're forced to do this. That's alright. Oh, it's too hard. Dang it.
The referee has indicated there will be a minimum.
Oh, jeez. I almost got that through. There we go. It's alright. I'm winning 1-0 right now. Ganando por, bueno, 1-0. Lo que pasa es que no pudimos hacer el otro modo, que se llama Ultimate Team, mi equipo último. Entonces decidimos hacer este partido solo de diversión para ver si funciona. Entonces lo que parece ser el problema es el hecho de que let me actually adjust some of these tactics. We got more time. Okay, that's cool. Some more instructions. I gotta let that go. That'll be good for now. Entonces toca hacer el partido de sí para ahora, pero no cuenta en sí, solo es diversión. Eso es lo que vamos a hacer. Pero eso está bien. That was high. I feel like the shooting's a bit different on this game mode compared to Ultimate Team. Oh no, that was gonna be a dangerous play. How far off was that? Oh, he skipped it. Is that right? Good save from his goalie. I should probably try and get in a little bit closer to get my shots off. They called it as a goal. Fair enough. Number 23, he's got in the right position. There we go, Lacazette's got some space. No, that pass was weak. Oh, that was close. Go. Musaf is a strong guy. It's hard to get past him. There we go. That's another nice goal. Good team play. That one actually was pretty nice, so I'm happy with that. I gave it right back to him, dang it. Cover the inside. Good goalie. Oh, the Utah Jazz? Sorry, I'm just now seeing that comment. That's cool. I don't watch too much of the NBA, but I know that's definitely the big team that they have out here in Utah. They got lots of supporters. People everywhere. I see wear jerseys from them and whatnot. So I think that's really cool. Bombing so fast. I think he's got like 96 pace or something. But I try to force that. I try to get the run on, but this guy doesn't high press at all, so he didn't actually switch to the player that received the ball. How did he get there? Dang it. I'm gonna try and draw a guy out. Corner kicks aren't very effective on FIFA 20. So he gets a guy on the top of the box. Get something you can hit it. Get the shot off at least. Do it again. Take another goal. Kind of running it up now. So hoping after this we can try another match an ultimate team and see if that'll work. That'd be a wild one. Yeah, the emojis don't show up on here, so I have no idea what that was. Please get there. Oh, almost kept it in. The cool thing about this guy, he doesn't really play very rush. He plays in a pretty calm way, which I can respect that. Ooh, the light's getting bad. There's so many players in the box. No, you gotta finish better than that. Go.
The fourth official has indicated there will be a minimum of 3 minutes of added time.
Here we go. Boom. Take that. All right, that's game. Let's see if we can't get a match on Ultimate Team now. That would be much more desirable. So he put us into a friendly season. Let's go to Ultimate Team. Even if we can't do this, I'll at least show you like the new team I have going for me. So there's a new squad I've got going now. Honestly, it's a pretty fresh squad. It moves really smoothly. So yeah, I got Neymar and Mbappe, two of like the fastest forwards right now, along with Salah, also really fast. I've seen Mbappe as a young talent. A lot of people know who Neymar is, and Salah's made a name for himself recently. Which Naldum is an all-around card. Every single stat is at least 80 and above. Really high. This guy, Ben Yedder, is incredible. I mean, he's got 5-star weak foot, 4-star skills, and his pace and shooting are 88 with 89 dribblings and a crazy attacking mid. He gets forward and creates opportunities to score. We got Mendy, who's a beast at the midfielder. I mean, the guy is 5'11". But he's got a 5-star weak foot as well. He tackles with both feet. But he's got 92 pace. He's got 84 defense, 88 physical. The guy's really strong. Of course, I got my wingbacks. Jordi Alba with 90 pace. Kyle Walker 91. So we got really fast outside backs that are strong and have good defensive skills so they can stop guys like mine that are the fast wingers. Also, really fast center back with good defense. Now, this is one that I would like to improve soon when I have more money, but this goalie is amazing. He's one of the best in the game. Yeah, he just told me to try it on Ultimate Team now. So I'm going to send him an invite. We go ahead and see if we can get that set up. Yeah, the team is looking pretty stacked, honestly. And then I ended up selling most of the guys I got and worked to get these guys on my team, and now it's honestly it's a really fluid squad. The interesting thing is that even though I play with that 4-3-3 with a deep defensive midfield style, in game I switch that to a 4-2-3-1. So there's two defensive mids, three attacking mids, and one striker. It's not gonna work. Basically, that's really effective because I can get one defensive mid to stay back, and they're tighter than before, versus the other one can be more free-roaming. He gets up, he moves around. My center attacking mid is free-roam, so he gets into the empty spaces on the field where he feels like he needs to be, and he's more likely to get the ball. The outside mids, they get forward, but they're not too far forward, so they're not right up on the outside backs. They can actually get the ball in space and then carry it forward to create opportunities from there because they're both really good on their feet. Which I think is really useful. Give me a second, I'm going to respond to this guy. I'm thinking we may have to try the match again tomorrow. So give me just a second to figure out what we're going to do here. Alright, so basically, potentially what we're going to be doing is just saying I won two of the potential three matches, because he, well, like you just saw, Ultimate Team isn't letting us play against each other right now, but we can play against each other with the other teams. He said I could just take the victory. He told me to take the W and that he'll take the L. Alright, so that's my first, I guess we'll say, somewhat legitimate victory this year on FIFA. Nice of the guy to try and make it work. He said he's 2-1 actually, so apparently he's won two other games. That's interesting. It's interesting. If he's won, what school is he playing for? Let me check that real quick. I know it's a school from Iowa. I just don't know if the actual name is on here. Iowa Central Tritons. It's another NJCAA school, but it's in Iowa. So I think I have to put the score in like this. Oh, he already put it on the score. He went ahead and put that I won 5-0. That works. Should I just play another game for fun just against someone online? Would you want to watch that? I can just do a random match and see how that goes. I wouldn't mind playing one more match and then going to work on some more homework. Entonces, Dan, no sé si estás ahí, pero lo que voy a hacer es jugar otro partido que solo es para diversión porque le gané al otro. Si quieres ver, lo puedes hacer, si no, pues también. Solo voy a jugar otro partido en línea, a ver. No, ni se permite eso. That's not even allowed right now, so I can't actually play any online matches even just like that. So there's no online matchmaking. That's a bummer. I would have liked to actually have shown off some of my new team. I can't do that though. That's disappointing. Well, as you can see, I have a decent squad. Would have been nice to have gotten to use it. I'll go over some of the stats, I guess, just to draw out the video a bit more. So you can see the stats down on the right side. You can see games played, goals scored, and assists. Obviously the smaller number on the right is the number of games I've had him, 6 games, because that's the current club. And in the 6 games, I've actually gotten 3 goals and 4 assists with him, which is, that's pretty awesome. He's involved with more than a goal per game. Mbappe has had 12 goals and 2 assists in 7 games. That's insane. And he's just so fast. It's honestly really impressive. Salah, I feel like he's a good player, but I haven't used him to his full potential. So I've gotten a goal and 4 assists in 7 games, but I feel like that's more on me. I've played a bit more down the left side than the right. I think his shooting's insane, though, because the one goal I scored with him was probably 20, 25 yards out, just a curler into the top corner, and I was just mind-blown. It was so impressive. Ben Yedder, also incredible. As an attacking mid, he scored 7 goals in 7 games, had 6 assists. He's been so involved, very constant. There's been games where he's been the guy who scored, and he's been the one who's made things happen. You got Mendy as well, 4 goals in 14 games. He is the defensive bit of my team, so I actually have him set to stay back more defensively. And yet he's still been a goal scorer for us 4 times. I think that's pretty impressive. Wijnaldum in 7 games, 3 goals and 4 assists. Again, this is a defensive mid, but I have him set more to go forward. Still, he's involved in a goal basically every game on average. I think that's awesome. I think that really is just so good. And obviously, these guys aren't going to be getting a lot of offensive stats, but honestly, they're amazing. Jordi Alba is just so fast. He's a great defender. I have the Sentinel card on him, which improves his defense and his physical, so he doesn't get knocked around so much. I think he's a little bit short. He's 5'7", so going against some of the other wingers, he does get bullied around a little bit. He's not as strong. His strength is 61 normally, but with the +8 boost, it actually goes up to 69, and his standing tackle is now 96. His slide tackle is now a 97. Defensive awareness is actually an 82, and his interceptions are an 87. I think that's really awesome. You can boost your player stats like that to make them better in the position they're in. Walker, on the other hand, is tall. He's 6 foot. As an outside back, that's really tall, and the dude's crazy fast. Honestly, crazy fast. I need to stick another card on him to adjust what stats I would actually like to improve, but overall, he's doing really well. I think I would want to make him also a bit stronger and potentially even a little bit better on defense, just so he can be a bit more locked down back there, but overall, he does really well. I think I really would want to improve his defensive awareness most of all, just so he's got a bit better positioning. This guy is amazing, honestly. He's another 6'3", really strong, good center back. With 83 pace, I mean, the guy can move, and with the upgraded speed I have on him is actually ridiculous. That gives him, if I'm not mistaken, 94 acceleration with 96 sprint speed. I mean, on a center back, that's just not normal. That's insane. His standing tackle, of course, is 91. With slide tackle, is actually 99. His defensive awareness is 97. He's got 88 heading accuracy and 92 interceptions, 86 strength. I mean, he's an animal. It's really hard for anyone to get by him. And a big plus is the fact that he's a good passer coming out of defense. He's got 75 short pass and 76 long passing. I think that's really important to have a center back that can not just win the ball, but then play it to someone else and get forward. So you can use that player to actually play out of the field. This is someone I'd like to replace. He's a decent defender that I have for now. He's obviously nowhere near as standout as the rest, but he's an athlete, and he's really physical back there. 6'2", again, he's a tall dude, and he's decently strong. He's got decent defense. He's got decent passing. He's got good speed. I think that's really useful. I have him for now because I don't have enough money to buy the next person I want to get, who's actually a 90-rated center back, which would be huge. His name is Van Dijk, so I'll actually look him up real quick, just so you can see his stats. And like 90 rated. So I can't afford any of the colorful ones you see on here. They look amazing. Honestly, super dope. But what I can do is eventually I want to buy one of these. Let's take a look at his stats. This guy is actually beast. Again, he's 6'4". He's even bigger than the other guy. And those are his base stats. His acceleration is 74, with sprint speed 79. When I stick some kind of upgrade card on him, he's going to be even faster. He'll be pushing high 80s. His standing tackle 92, slide tackling 85, defense awareness 91, heading accuracy 86, interceptions 89. I mean, those are his base stats. Again, when I upgraded him, when I put that card in him that will make him faster and even better tactically, it's gonna be out of this world. His strength is already a 92 with 90 jumping. I mean, he's already 6'4" and he can jump like so high. 88 reactions, so he reacts really fast. And 76 ball control with 70 dribbling. On a center back, that's actually pretty impressive that he can control the ball like that. And looking at his passing, it's actually even better than the other center back I just showed you. With 78 short passing, 81 long passing, he can play the ball out of defense just so easily. And he's going to be an animal when I have him back on defense. When I get him in there, it's going to be lockdown. I meant to look at the goalkeeper too, so we'll take a look at him real quick. As you can see, his stats also very impressive. He is 89 rated and 6'3", tall goalie, so he covers out of the goal. And because of the card that I have placed on him that boosts his attributes, his positioning you see on the far right is actually 99 because it gets the plus 9. His reflexes are 89, which is amazing. His kicking is 85. I mean, that's just extra, honestly. That's really awesome. His handling comes out to 99, and his diving also comes out to 99. So when you've got the right cards in these players, you can really bring out even greater abilities in them. And it just he's such a good goalie. Honestly, he saved me in some tough situations. And I know it seems like a joke, but I do want to point out that this, I still feel like, may actually be the best goalie I've ever used in the game. And he looks totally normal. Like, he's 80 rated, 82 diving, 84 reflexes is pretty good, and 79 positioning. But what's so crazy about him is he's 6'6", so he fills up the whole goal when he opens up his arms. And I swear he's just always in the right place. And he's just so big, he doesn't have to move as fast. He's just there. And it's funny because he's just a cheap player. I use him on my extra team that's just for maintaining my team's fitness levels. Really impressive. It's just good to have him on the team. But yeah, this is the team that I play with. And it's a fun one. It's really fast. I think the midfield is as good as I'll ever want it to be. They're all very quick, good ball control, two really good ball winners, and all three of them can take shots, especially these two. So the midfield is great. Improve that center back. I will never want to change the center backs, I think. I think I'll be really happy with them. The outside backs also are as good as they want them. The goalie, there's one other goalie that's in debate, but chemistry-wise, he's the best. And these guys are just ridiculous. Obviously, I don't have Ronaldo. I don't have Messi. But these are the next best guys. And some would even argue that some of them honestly are the best. Because Mbappe, if you take a look at his stats, 96 acceleration, 96 sprint speed. He's just so fast. And with the card that I've stuck on him, his finishing, which is your ability to shoot inside the goal box, is 99. His shot power is 88. His attack positioning with the plus 5 is also a 94, so he's in the right place, and as fast as he is, he just gets there. His long shots are good too, with 89. I mean, that's really impressive. Volley is also 89. It's mad. When you take a look at his dribbling, also insane. Go down to the dribbling stat, it actually comes out to a 96, ball control 95, reactions are 94, and his agility is a 97. I mean, the guy can just change direction so fast. Also with 86 jumping and 81 strength, I mean, that's impressive. The guy's 5'10", so he's about my height, but he can run. Dude is so fast. Salah as well, just really fast player. 94 acceleration, 92 sprint speed. And I've got the card on him that boosts his shooting, his passing, and his dribbling, which I think are the things that you definitely want to have shine on your outside wingers, because they got to get up the field, be able to do something with the ball on their feet. Mbappe is one day younger than me? Wait a second. I didn't actually see his birthday. Oh, shoot. How about that? He's 21, just like I am. And he turns 22 one day after I do. That's pretty wild. He'll he's already been doing a lot for his age. Neymar also is a really crazy card because he's got 5-star skills, but also has a 5-star weak foot, which means both feet are equally as good, which is insane. He can do the same thing with both feet. That's amazing. I do think I want to change the chemistry style I have on him to adjust, make his passing better. But he's crazy fast with those stats. He's got 99 acceleration and 97 sprint speed. Super, super fast. Attack positioning comes out to 91. Finishing, 91. Shot power, 88. Long shots, 84 is actually really good, too. His volleys are 99, and his penalties also 99. It's just a ridiculous stat. And he's a really good playmaker, too. With 90 vision means he can see a lot of the players that are around him. Crossing 87, which is great. Free kick accuracy also 87, that is great. 87 short passing, 81 long passing, 88 curve. Honestly, really, really impressive. His agility, 96 with 84 balance, 92 reactions, 95 ball control, 96 dribbling, 94 composure. It's mad. Honestly, what he can do with the ball at his feet is just so impressive. And the composure thing actually isn't just useful when it comes to dribbling. That also affects how well he's going to take on shots. If he has really high composure, then even when he's off balance or when there's a defender close to him, he's going to be able to take the shot comfortably the way that he wants to without being effective. So I think that's actually a really important stat to have on your players. But really, I think that's about all I wanted to go over, since I can't really seem to get any games right now. It's pretty disappointing. But I can try one more time. I don't think it'll let me, but I would like to actually get a game in with them. Create a game session. Searching for opponent. Maybe they fixed it. I'd be pretty excited if they did. Hope I can pull off the win, though. Oh, my back. Oh, I just cracked everything. That was the last one, I think. Well, if anyone's online, there's that too. So we gotta see if someone else will get on. And we can get one game in. See how that turns out. It's kind of been a problem all day. I try to get on earlier just so I could get in a couple of practice matches and see how it'd work out. Just make sure I felt good before going to the actual game. But EA had everything shut down for some reason. I guess they were patching something. I heard they released an update for FIFA 21, and it didn't work out. Or I guess maybe it did, but it triggered something in FIFA 20, so it also caused the reset. And this guy's team looks pretty good. Defensively, he actually looks really impressive. His midfield looks really strong. Going forward, he's not fast, but those players look good. Entonces, amor, no sé si estás viendo, pero allá voy a empezar otro partido. No cuenta para nada, pero por lo menos sí puedo estar en línea. It is getting pretty cold out here. This morning, actually, when we stepped outside to go training, it was 36 degrees. And I was just like, you gotta be kidding me. So you see, on the bottom right, I switched over to defensive. I do that because the way I've got my team set up in the defensive tactics switches me to a 4-2-3-1, so I don't have to pause it or anything and switch things around. It's already there, which I think is pretty useful. Honestly, I like having it there. Just it makes things faster. Gets the players where I want them. I wasted that, honestly. I did the wrong move. I pulled back on accident. That's on me.
Crap.
No! Dang it. Oh my goodness. Why? Yeah, 30s are really cold. Go ahead, plug it in. Sorry you can't put the volume on loud. But no, I just wasted some decent opportunities I had against this guy. I gotta get more clinical. I just need to play more seriously. I think sometimes I start to joke around just because I feel like it's not that hard. Or maybe even just because I'm videoing and I don't think I focus properly. That's gotta be offsides. Here we go. Did he stop playing? Of course he started right then. So I can get a double team on the outside. Forced him in. The guy's like not even playing, but I still can't get in there just because he's got so many players in the box. This is disappointing. I would have liked to have gotten a real game in, but the guy's not even there. Sound and power.
Goal for the visitors. Number 7, Neymar.
Dang it. Well, the guy doesn't just play. This is annoying. I don't know what this guy is doing. I'm sorry. He's not gonna play if he just quit so I can get in a real match. So he is playing. I can't figure out what this guy's doing. I don't know why he won't just end it. It's actually kind of annoying. I'd like to put in a good game for you guys. Like, he's there because he does stuff like that. Like, he's not actually gone, but he's not playing either. And it's a corner. And I want to see what happens whenever he's not playing, if his defenders will automatically. And his goalie came out. Well, Neymar's got a strike on him. Even if he is playing, that's not stopping a shot like that. Está haciendo mucho. Siento que el partido no debe de ser así. Pero man ni está jugando. ¿Qué hace? Hace lujo así, pero no hace nada ya con el balón. This is annoying. Like, I guess it's okay. I get a free win, basically, but I don't like things to be free like that. Dang it. Read it, and he still bounced to him.
The fourth official has indicated there will be a minimum of 2 minutes of added time.
Please be onside. Ah! I hope he just ends it, unless he's gonna actually play in the second half. I mean, he hasn't done anything with it. It's whatever. I mean, the only people that are actually kind of tired in the team are my striker attacking mid and my right winger, because they're the only ones that have actually gotten to do anything with the ball. I'm doing way too much with him. Finish it, finish it! No! Dang it. That was a decent play though. I think a lot of people underplay how important it is to read the game in FIFA, where players are going to be. I know sometimes I do sloppy stuff because I'm messing around, but... Oh, I did the wrong move. You always got to be looking for triangles and see where the guy might pass it whenever he gets the ball to the other player. And force certain plays. Right now I forced him down the line, but oof, good save for my goalie. Would have been better if I could have blocked the cross. Nope. Yes, no. Sergio Ramos is a great center back, by the way. One of the best of all time. He did a good job of reading me there, but my defenders are too fast. Oh my goodness, that was so close. I think that's something a lot of people miss out on whenever they're playing FIFA or even soccer and real life, or football for that matter. Looking for the third player run. Because a lot of times you play the ball to someone and you expect the 1-2 back to that guy. But if you can actually play the ball to someone, give it to someone else, you find they have a totally different angle that's open to the space that they're running to. A lot of defenders are really quick to cut off what, you know, it would be that first pass back. But it's really hard to actually cover the third angle. It's really hard for one person to cover three people. That's why triangles are so dangerous in soccer. But if you have one person between two, you cut off the one angle they had. Versus if you have one person versus three, you're going to find that there's always going to be two lanes open at a time. It just increases your chances of maintaining possession substantially. It really is impressive. That touch was heavy. It worked out though. Not to him. That's not how I wanted to go to. I wasn't ready for that. Run, Neymar. And you guys pressuring hard. Wijnaldum's not that fast. I saw that coming. Dang it. My goalie's gotta be there for that. That's what I mean about those triangles. I probably should have went ahead and lifted that through. Oh, I saw that coming though. Why has he got so much space? That was stupid.
Goal for the hosts. Number 5, Edinson Cavani.
Why did he fall like that? Run. Oh, it's lagging so bad. The ball's supposed to be right now. That lag was pretty nasty. That's Salah. What a shot.
Goal for the visitors. Number 11, Mohamed Salah.
Oh, that was almost clean. Run. No way did he save that. Dang it.
Substitution for the host. Coming off the pitch.
That play on the sideline was nice, though.
16, Luis Suarez. To be replaced by number 13, Sadio Mane.
Oh, it started lagging. Crap. Okay, Neymar getting back on defense. Okay. That's a dangerous tackle. Not the move I wanted to do right there. What a goal. Jeez, that was clean. No, no mercy rules. That'd be nice though. Here on campus, we have a rule between us as players that if it gets to 3-0, you should end the game, but online, there's nothing like that. The thing is, what was the score at halftime? 5-0? You know, if we had like really been playing, it's like saying it would have been 3-1, which, or at least this half. Really, if you want to double that, probably would have scored 6 goals in the game. Mbappe getting his match ball with his hat trick. The reality is, I don't consider that to have been much of a game, unfortunately. The way things played out. Just because the guy wasn't involved in the first half. But in the second half, I looked like I did alright. So we get one more game in, just for fun. Un partido más solo para diversión. A ver lo que sale. I see I'm not a really high division yet. I'm just now, working my way up. Go ahead and put some more contracts on him. It's a nice sound. That's a pleasing sound. Pretty sure everyone's healthy. Yeah. Need one more game in with these guys and then we'll call it a night. Next time I play, I'll play with the other squad and give them fitness again. So I don't know who all is watching right now. I see there's four viewers. But essentially, I play for the esports team at Utah State University Eastern out here in Price, Utah. And I play for the soccer team, really, but I found out that they had FIFA too, so I thought I'd give it a go. And today I already played a game against somebody. We basically play against other teams that are also from the NJCAA conference here out west. And the same teams that I play on a soccer field are same guys I play against here on FIFA. So it's pretty cool. It's fun. It's something different for me, something I haven't done before that competitively. But that's just a way to have fun, really, I think. And yeah, today we won. Unfortunately, we couldn't play on Ultimate Team because there was something wrong with the servers. They were down most of the day, but we did get to play a match on regular, I guess, seasons it would be. We played with regular teams. We played with Tottenham, I played with Arsenal, and I won 5-0, so it counted as a win for the school today. Hopefully next time I can actually be with Ultimate Team because I've been working pretty hard to put together a quality squad, like you can see. And so we're doing matches for fun now. Now this team looks pretty insane. 93 rated overall. Honestly, every player out there looks really dangerous. That's all right. The tricky part will probably be breaking down his midfield because he's playing a 4-4-1-1. It's really tight in the center. And on the outside, he's got two players on each side as well, so it can be pretty thick. However, if he doesn't have his team tactics properly organized, it's very likely his center mids will be set to cover the wing, which means that's a penalty. That's a free kick. Or is it called a penalty? I shielded it just before he actually got to the ball. Too soft. That wasn't a bad effort, though. Man, he really runs out there with his goalie, doesn't he? I draw my center back inside. That's something about the premonition. Obviously, I got kind of lucky there with a bit of a bounce, but I knew to draw my center back inside, which I think is something really important in actual soccer as well. In real soccer, it's called rolling and covering. Oh, it got away from him. He ran too fast. I didn't need to hold the sprint button there. That's on me. This guy's team feels really fast, though. That's a dangerous ball. Good block. We'll take that. He really draws back his forwards when he defends, which will probably wear them out. At the end of the game, they won't be that dangerous. Yeah, we'll get somewhere soon. Really? He can't get there? That's all right. Hey, dog. How you doing?
Pretty good. How are you?
Doing all right. Good to see you. Well, I won today. Probably esports game. This is just an extra game for fun. I beat the guy 5-0. Good keep. Got no one to call your goalie out to. Thing is, this guy's team is like really super. Oof. That's enough to dry. And he read that. I should have turned. Crush it across it. I just don't trust the crossing system in this game because you can't score headers. It just basically doesn't allow it. Dang it, near post OP. It's disappointing. I gave him too much space on the near post. No, you gotta get that through. Dang. Not the move I wanted. The high pressure was on. No, no! I just... Oh, you gotta be kidding me. He just got so lucky. I clicked to pass it, but it took way too long. He's just getting knocked around, I guess. He wasn't strong enough. Got back for that. Not quite where I wanted that pass to go. I don't know how that got through. He actually not made my goalie. I wanted to do a move there and it didn't do anything. That's gotta be off. That was a disappointing first half. Trying to turn that around. Disappointing. I should have been able to score that goal. That opportunity gave me really easy, but my players got knocked around and couldn't get the shot off. It's alright. I gotta create more scoring opportunities. I'm dribbling too much. I think I enjoy it too much because my players are good at dribbling, but I force them to do things that are difficult. Gotta play a more simple brand of soccer. Really? There we go. That's better. We're gonna get this back. I would have liked to have gone clear the first time when I got the ball with Mbappe right there, but it was kind of tight, so I was forced to shield a little bit. This is so open. No way, it's a penalty. A red card. No. Okay. That was so stupid. I saved the ball and everything.
The host, number 21, Thiago.
I just forced that. No reason for me to throw that out right there. It's outsides, okay. No, that was right there. Oh, no way. He's getting every bounce. And they want to call that as a foul on me. No! Missed that too. This has been so unlucky. No. Why are you dropping in like that? No, 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 not like that. Jeez. Wrong guy. Gosh, he just got absolutely stuffed right there. Come on. Well, this sucks. Yeah, that was a brilliant shot, honestly. Impressive. great save by his goalie. He's already calling his goalie out, jeez. You kidding me? I'm gonna score nice goals too. Just gets the ball fast down the line and gets it across. And it falls in the perfect places like that, jeez. Dang, he drilled that. Are you kidding me? How you missed that? It's another easy opportunity where I feel like I just got screwed on, even though like I was in the right place, right time. It didn't come off though. Gosh. That should have been an easy goal. Not gonna lie. No. Okay. Every bit of that was sloppy. Oh, why'd you step away, Mbappe? I gave you the space. I drew the defender. Yes, I felt like that was a smart move on my part, but he didn't go to the right place. That's disappointing. Felt like I put together some good plays in there. It's interesting, even when I lose, I always get man of the match. I think it goes to show like I do good things with my players. But the finishing wasn't there. And 6 shots and 2 went in. Oh well, that happens. Like I said, that one was just for fun. Anyway, I think that's going to be it for today. Just because for me to get off the red card, I'm going to have to play another match with another squad, and I'd rather not right now. I'm going to take care of stuff for college. I'm going to have to take care of that red card, and that's going to take a match. And that's the guy I want to replace too. That was a dumb foul. But thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. Sorry I couldn't get in the real match today, but at least there were a few matches to be watched. So I appreciate your support again, seriously. Thank you all. So yeah. You guys have a good night. Everyone take care. I'll sleep tight. Bye bye.